Tonight we have team coverage as Central Texas battles this heat wave, but we start with Jim Spencer in the First Warning Weather Center.
You're right, our high today 103 makes it day 32, and now two straight weeks of it. 14 days in a row that we've seen temperatures at 100 degrees or above. We're only 7 days away now from the record of 21, and we just might get there. Partly sunny out there right now. Temperatures just dropped from 103 to 102. At this hour. Now, typically in mid-July, we're talking mid-90s. That's the average. But that normal is creeping higher. Meteorologist Natalie Stoll is live at Auditorium Shores with more on our new averages. Natalie?
Hi, Jim. Well, if you stand out here, you get the full effect of 100-degree temperatures. And on average, we see 12 100-degree days in a typical summer. But scientists have now reevaluated climate normals. And over the past 30 years, it could be more accurate to say 16, 17, or even 18 100-degree days a summer are normal.
Here we go. You ready? Go.
I feel like the temperatures have been pretty high, higher than usual.
Miranda Coletta is right. But what's considered a normal high temperature is changing. Every 10 years, the National Climatic Data Center re-averages the temperature and precipitation data over the past 30 years.
And by taking the data from 1981 to 2010, we're now dropping the 70s. And we're picking up the decade of 2001 to 2010.
And the new normal temperatures are warmer.
And that's a reflection of the fact that we've had a number of record warm years in the decade that ended in 2010, and so that influences the data.
The average daytime high temperature at Camp Mabry in July is 95 degrees. The new 30-year average high is 95.6 degrees. August's average high is now 97 instead of 95.6. It's a trend noticeable almost every month. But George cautions against blaming global warming, even with our hot and dry trend.
The last 10 months or so have been reminiscent to me of the horrible drought year of 1956.
The drought of record when Lake Travis hit its all-time low. That next spring in 1957, the skies opened up.
It was probably the most dramatic ending to a drought that Texas has ever experienced since statehood. I'm hoping that this is our 1956.
Others aren't so optimistic.
Deep down, I'm a little more pessimistic, but a little more pessimistic deep down, but I hope it's a cycle.
Now the National Weather Service will start using those new normals on August 1st. We've put that information on our website tonight for both Austin and some other Central Texas cities. Go to KXAN.com and look for this story under the local news tab. In South Austin, Natalie Stoll, KXAN News.
Precious rain in other parts of Texas is helping to keep the ERCOT power grid from the critical stage. It was a different story yesterday. High heat forced ERCOT to ask folks in Texas to conserve during the peak hours. In fact, we set another new record for electricity usage in July. The previous high demand in July prior to this year was back on July 13, 2009. The all-time peak demand record was set on August 23rd of last